There has been a lot of excitement recently about the email from ClickUp feature, which will allow you to send emails from ClickUp, either from a task or using automations from any task in a whole list. But today I want to talk about the reverse, kind of an old tried and true feature that I don't think gets enough love in ClickUp, which is the forwarding emails to ClickUp feature. The way this works is you can send emails directly to a unique email address, which turns your email into either a comment on a task or a new task. That was weird, but oh well. In this tutorial, you're going to learn how you can create tasks automatically using an email filter forwarding into your unique email address for a specific list in your ClickUp account. No special features or paid accounts are required to use this feature. Just make sure you have a ClickUp account, at least on the free plan. And if you don't, use my affiliate link to join. And you should be able to use this tutorial for your own business to forward emails into your own ClickUp account. So without further ado, let's just dive in. The very first decision we have about the email to ClickUp feature is where do we want our email to end up? We have two options, so we want to just choose right off the bat so we know what we're building. The first option is to have our emails show up as comments. The second option is to have our emails become new tasks, not comments on an existing one. So let's just demonstrate both of those here so we both get some practice. If we wanted to have our forwarded emails become comments on this task here, we would open the task, click on the three dots, and locate the unique email address for this task. Just to remind you, you have one of these that is completely unique for every single task that you have. So I'm going to copy this. Then I'm going to go ahead and put this into my just normal email tool. So I'm going to go over here to email. I could forward an existing email like this one here, forward that over, or I could create a new email and send it to this address. So I'm just going to go ahead and paste that email address I guess just copied. This is an email. Hello, this is the body. Send. So I just send an email to the email address of the task. And if I actually look at the sent email, you'll see that it changed the contact name to be example task because that is the name of the task we're working on. So pay attention to this because that means your contact in your address book, because this is a contact now that you're emailing, is going to automatically become the task name, which is really, really convenient. It makes it a lot easier for in the future, if you want to send another email to this email address, you could just type in example task and there you go. So let's go ahead and look at what this looks like inside ClickUp. Here we can now see that we have the email forwarded into a task comment inside ClickUp, and it shows as from me, it says, hello, this is the body, and then it has my signature there. Now notice our email has now become a comment inside ClickUp. They knew it was from me. They pulled the body into the comment. They did not actually pull in the subject line of the email, but they did pull in my entire signature in sort of an ugly way. Now this isn't the prettiest, but this can be a really great tool to use if you are using tasks to keep track of something like an order or a client. You can then just forward your communications to the specific task to help keep all of your communication logs together. To illustrate the second way of adding tasks to ClickUp, we need to go to the list email address, which is down here under the email address. And once again, we can just copy the email address. Now notice that this pop-up has a few other details. Here, it's gonna actually acknowledge the subject line. It's going to pull in the due date. It should do a lot more for us if we wanted to add those elements into the actual email that we're sending. So we're just gonna go ahead and type up an email and send it to that new email address. Now all I need to do is paste in the email address of my list, and you'll see it automatically pulled in the name of the list as well, which is the example list. That's what it's called right here. All right, and now I can go ahead and click send. So we waited a little bit, and about a minute or so after I sent that email, we saw this task appear inside ClickUp. And as we saw in the modal giving us some instructions, that task name is pulled from the subject line of the email. So now we have emails being forwarded into ClickUp. As long as we're only forwarding in a few places, taking the time to add these email addresses into our contacts book can make adding emails into ClickUp quite easy. But what if we are in a situation where we're constantly getting emails of a certain type that we always want to have come into ClickUp no matter what? Well, it can become a little time consuming to go ahead and forward them every single time, which is kind of a waste of your time. So that's what I want to show you for the remainder of this tutorial. We're actually going to go in and set up a filter so that we automatically forward tasks into ClickUp. But before we dive into the last piece of this tutorial, if you've gotten value out of the video so far, I would really appreciate it if you give this video a thumbs up and leave a comment below. Those actions cost you nothing, but they help this video reach a whole lot more people, and I would really appreciate it. Consider it like the price of admission for this free content. Maybe, yeah? Thank you for giving that thumbs up. All right, let's dive into this last piece of the puzzle. For this last piece, we're actually not gonna be setting up any automations in ClickUp. These automations are happening in our inbox. Now, I'm using Google Inbox right here. If you are using Outlook, very similar process. What we're gonna do is set up a filter. Now, in G Suite, this is up here, where we can actually create any kind of query and then create a filter from it. In this case, I'm just gonna say any email that's from myself I want to have it forwarded into ClickUp. So I'm just going to say create a filter because there's no other criteria I want here. I could get a lot more specific, but I don't think that's necessary. Create filter. And what I want to have happen, that's what this is telling me here. So my first piece was my when, my triggers. And this next piece is what do I want to have happen? So I think what I want to have happen is have it mark as read and skip the inbox, meaning I don't really want to see it because it's going into ClickUp and I don't want to have to look at it twice. And I'm going to have it forward. Now I'm going to add a forwarding address here, which is going to be the ClickUp email address. I have a choice here if I want to do the list address or the task address. I'm going to go with the list address, meaning every time an email comes from me to me, it'll create a new unique task inside the list that I choose. So in this case, I'm going to go back to my test list. I'm going to go in here and I'm going to grab that email address again. I know it's already saved to my contacts, but now I forget what it's called. So I'm just going to re-pull it in. So when I click continue, it takes me into the settings of G Suite where I can actually add a forwarding email address. I have to have consent to forward my emails automatically somewhere else. So we have to take a second and set that up. So I'm going to click add a forwarding address and paste the long URL that is my list email address. Just a note, because I just had this issue here, make sure that you remove the actual name information. That's really helpful if you're emailing directly, but because we're just using the email address, I'm going to just get rid of everything else except the email address. Okay, I'm going to click continue. Here we say forwarding mail, blah, 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 proceed. And it says a confirmation code has been sent. Now, when I first saw this last year, when I was setting things up, I remember being very frustrated thinking, oh no, I need to confirm the email address and I don't own the email address. How am I ever gonna do this? Well, lucky for us, the email to ClickUp feature is smart enough to know that this confirmation needs to happen. So this forwarding address confirmation actually ends up right here as a new task in the ClickUp list. So I can click inside this, or if you were using the task comment, it would show up as the task comment, depends where you're forwarding to. So here, all we really need to do is click this confirmation link inside the task, which is really the confirmation email, to get this whole thing up and running. I'm gonna click this link. It'll ask me to confirm. I'll click confirm. And now I'm able to forward emails. So this is just giving me permission. Now I wanna make sure that my filter is set up to actually do it. So now when I go to create a new filter inside Gmail, go in here. In this case, it's just gonna be whatever's from me. Click create filter, continue. Now I should have the option to forward to the list. So now anytime an email gets sent to that email address, this is going to get forwarded. So now I can test this out by actually sending myself an email with some very helpful information, clicking send and going into ClickUp to see what happens. Because remember, I didn't send it directly to the email address. I just have it automatically pulling in any emails from myself and forwarding them to ClickUp. So it'll take about a minute for that email to come in, but while we wait, I just want to explain why you might use this feature. One really common way is if you have a bunch of large clients that you're frequently working with, any email coming from a certain domain, so at johndoe.com, you can say any email like that, forward a copy of it to one task in ClickUp where you have John Doe equals a task and you have one comment section with every email you've ever sent them. Another common use case might be if you have another system that you're working with that often shoots off automated emails, like maybe, you know, form's been submitted, proposal's been accepted, something like that. And you know, every time an email with a certain subject line comes in, you know what that means and it needs to end up in ClickUp. Well, rather than you even looking at it in your inbox, you can have ClickUp do that kind of busy work of sorting it over for you. So every time a consult comes in, you could automatically have it forward and create a new lead inside of ClickUp. I know this is a very common setup for people in real estate, lawyers, and accountants, where you have back-end systems that are shooting off a lot of automated emails that you don't really need to see and you'd rather them just be forwarded along. You'll set up an automation like this inside your inbox so that way all those emails get collected directly into ClickUp without you having to worry about them. This cuts you out of being the middleman, especially if the end person who needs to resolve those emails are people on your team who do not have access to your own inbox. Oh, and that reminds me, our email has arrived and here it is inside the system. So you can see it was automatically forwarded thanks to the filter, not even using any ClickUp automations, but to automatically create a task here inside ClickUp. So in conclusion, this is how you can email tasks directly into ClickUp automatically using filters with parameters that you get to define that can be super dialed in. If you'd like to learn about the other direction of this feature where you can actually email from ClickUp, you might want to watch this video next. Otherwise, the next place you want to go is our automations playlist because we are covering a whole lot about ClickUp automations inside and outside the tool on this playlist here. So just click on it and just click here. Okay, thank you guys so much for watching. Until next time, enjoy the process.